Hello everyone. It is a common practice among many dental practitioners to do intentional root canal treatment of vital abutment teeth before placing a full coverage restoration, that is a crown or fixed partial denture. Is it ideal to do root canal treatment before crown or FPD placement, or is it unnecessary which would compromise the health of the tooth? In this presentation, we are going to analyze the need and drawbacks of intentional root canal treatment before crown or FPD placement. I hope this video will be really helpful for practitioners and dental students to make an evidence-based decision before doing this procedure. First of all, we have to analyze why dentists prefer to do intentional root canal treatment. If intentional root canal treatment is performed, then there is no chance for post-operative sensitivity after placement of crown or fixed partial denture. If there is a leakage in the margin of the restoration that we place, there can be profuse sensitivity reported by the patient. So this can be avoided by doing an intentional root canal treatment. It also can lead to accidental pulp exposure at the time of tooth preparation for vital crown, especially in case of young patients, and if the pulp horn is too big or prominent, then the chances for pulp exposure is manifold increased. So this also can be avoided by doing an intentional root canal treatment. Otherwise, at the time of tooth preparation, there can be a pulp exposure and it will be a difficult situation for the dentist to inform the patient and convince the patient that the tooth needs an root canal treatment. Many dentists consider that if there is a chance for pain to occur in the future, root canal treatment will be very difficult. For example, there could be development of secondary caries in a crown tooth, or there could be some other problems which can occur in a root canal treated tooth after placement of the crown. Doing a root canal treatment through the crown or removing the crown doing the treatment will be tedious. So this can be avoided previously itself if you are doing intentional root canal treatment. Next important reason that the dentist prefer to do intentional root canal treatment is adequate reduction can be given for the restorative procedure. For example, ceramic restorations recurs at least to a thickness of around 2 millimeters. In a vital tooth, maintaining the proper anatomy and giving a reduction of around 2 millimeter will be very difficult. This can be avoided by doing an intentional root canal treatment, so adequate reduction can be made while doing the tooth preparation. There are so many advantages which are claimed by the dentist. So let's analyze what are the reasons that we should never perform an intentional root canal treatment, or what are the things which are lost in a tooth after doing intentional root canal treatment. The most important among all these things is there will be no defense mechanism. In a vital tooth, there will be odontoblastic process, there will be dentinal fluid movement, there will be cells which all take care and will prevent the progression of the dental caries and give signal whenever there is an initial caries, like in the form of sensitivity, telling us that there is a problem in the tooth, take care of it immediately. But after doing intentional root canal treatment, there will be no intimation given by the tooth whatever the disease is progressing. And next, the chances for secondary caries to occur and also to progress is manifold high in case of intentional root canal treated tooth or any root canal treated tooth, because there will be no defense mechanism. Because of that, there will be more chance for secondary caries, rapid progression of dental caries, and which can lead to deleterious effects. Next important reason is the structural loss. By preparing an access cavity preparation, doing cleaning and shaping, there is an enormous loss of tooth structure which is lost. This can lead to easy fracture of the tooth in the future, and it can make the tooth weaker during masticatory forces. Any root canal treated tooth will also lose moisture and it will become more brittle. We can see that many root canal treated tooth which are not crowned will lead to brittle fracture of the tooth, and patient reports with fractured tooth. In root canal treated teeth, the proprioception is minimal or it's lost completely. So whenever the patient is using the tooth, the amount of force which is applied to the tooth during mastication is uncontrolled. They cannot judge how much force is applied, and that can lead to more chances for fracture. A vital tooth, when we proceed or when we do intentional root canal treatment, there can be a various anatomy which can lead to missed canals. There can be an instrument separation while doing the procedure, which can lead to procedural errors like perforation, can lead to ledge formation, can lead to canal blockade, or there are many instances that we may not be able to do a successful root canal treatment. A vital tooth which is otherwise normal is indicated for intentional root canal treatment, and if you are not able to perform the root canal treatment to a high success, then we are compromising the success of the tooth and also the success of the restorative procedures. Looking into all these factors, it can be considered that intentional root canal treatment before placing a FPD or a full coverage restoration is not an ideal. But is it that intentional root canal treatment should be always avoided? No, there are many indications where we may have to go for intentional root canal treatment. At first, whenever there is a severe attrition, in those situations, the occlusal reductions cannot be made. In those situations, we may have to go for intentional root canal treatment. Whenever the tooth is tilted or angulated, and whenever we are going for a full coverage restoration, changing the angulation, then their chances for the pulp exposure are more. In these situations, we may have to go for an intentional root canal treatment. Occasionally, there can be a grossly disrupted tooth which will have a shell of the outer surface of the tooth remaining, but the tooth may be vital. In those situations, if you are going for a full coverage restoration or any other restorative procedures, there will be inadequate retention. So in order to provide an adequate retention, we may have to take support from intracoronal region, that is maybe from the access cavity or from the intraradicular space, like providing a postant core. In those situations, we may have to go for an intentional root canal treatment. Those teeth with patients giving symptoms which can be considered, which is not reliable, or it could give some symptoms of irreversible pulpal damage, then it is better to do an intentional root canal treatment before initiating any other procedures. Because after placing a full coverage restoration, if pain develops, then it will be very difficult to proceed with doing root canal treatment. Very often patients report with supraerupted teeth. These supraerupted teeth will have no other options for re-establishing the occlusion other than doing an intentional root canal treatment, reducing the occlusal height, and placement of a full coverage restoration. In those situations, it is mandatory and it is well indicated that we may have to go for an intentional root canal treatment. The other treatment option would be an orthodontic intrusion, which is not possible in many instances, or it is quietly, highly time consuming, or in older patients it is not possible. Whenever there are deep abrasions which are very close to the pulp, there can be more chances for the tooth which is already non-vital, which may be asymptomatic, but the tooth could be non-vital. Whenever there are deep cervical abrasions, then it is better to go for an intentional root canal treatment. Traumatized teeth and fractured teeth may be asymptomatic at present, but more often any traumatized teeth which is luxated, intruded, extruded, or which is splinted, or if there is some tooth fractures, maybe a dentinal or pulpal exposure, may require an intentional root canal treatment. The tooth may be vital at present, but in the future, the chances that it becomes non-vital are much more. So those teeth can be treated intentionally. In certain cases of smile designing, where there should be some alignment correction or diastema closure, then in those situations, we may have to go for an intentional root canal treatment. And at last, secondary to periodontal diseases, while doing a periodontal treatment, the tooth might require an intentional root canal treatment. In those situations, it is essential and it is very needed that we have to go for an intentional root canal treatment. Taking into all these points into our consideration, a tooth is glorious, it is vital, and it is healthy. By doing a root canal treatment, actually we are not doing something good for the tooth, actually we are destroying the tooth. So before doing intentional root canal treatment, it is the responsibility of each and every dentist to analyze and take all these points into kind considerations, and a proper treatment planning should be devised. Studies have shown that a root canal treated tooth lives lesser than a vital tooth. So a vital crown placement or a fixed partial denture with vital teeth as the abutment will have a longer life compared to that of fixed partial denture with root canal treated teeth as abutments, or a single tooth which is root canal treated which is having single crown. So root canal treatment should be chosen and have to be performed only when it is mandatorily required before placement of full coverage restoration or fixed partial denture. Unnecessarily doing root canal treatment should not be promoted and it should be avoided. Thanks a lot for watching. Have a nice day.